ሲክል ሲሆን ሌሎችን ተከትለው ይሰሩታል ማለት ነው ሌላው ሪፕሮዲዩሲብል doesn't matter on the number of experiments that we run it has to remain always the same and the third is communicable that it has to be used for other scholars that's why we most of the time when we write a project proposal on the content of methodology we try to look how it was done previously why because we try to seek the correct methodology so that we can conduct our experiment so if it is a correct methodology it means the procedure is repeatable and it will be reproducible and it will be communicable if not if we distort or if we are again scientific conduct meaning if we carry out the seven scientific misconduct methodology will also be affected all right this step is again stuck on okay now the seven scientific misconducts have been there for centuries and they are still with us up to now the most dangerous scientific misconduct is this one let me go first with the questions the current issues in scientific integrity let me ask you how is the trend of scientific publication in Ethiopia during the last few decades I'm asking you and the second question is do you ever receive an email with warm greetings and request for submitting a manuscript attending upcoming conference requesting to be an editorial member yes or no mostly yes yeah as a middle level and senior researcher this is quite common now my question is what is your feedback to such requests and what do you advise your colleague በኢሜላችሁ መቼም የማይመጣ የለም በተለይ የዩኒቨርሲቲ ወይም ኢንስቲትዩሽናል ኢሜል ከሆነ እንደ ጉድ ይመጣል እኛ እንደ አይነት ጆርናል ስለሆነ እዚህ ጋር በጣም ሲቪ ስናየው ሪስፔክትድ ፕሮፌሰር ሪስፔክትድ ሪሰርቸር ስሙን ካፕ አድርጎ ነው የሚልኩልንና አምጣ ማንስክሪፕት ነው ይሄ የተለመደ ነው አይደል what do you do you submit or not Exactly. We have to first check whether it is a legitimate or illegitimate journal or publisher. But nowadays it is quite common. Our emails are honestly being flooded. Flooded by what? Requesting for submission of manuscript most of the time. And sometimes to participate on a fake conference where it's not there at all, but they call it a conference. Just a fake conference for the sake of money. And of course, who shall be member of editorial members most senior scholars senior scientists researchers right and of course review paper writers or those who are contacted to submit a review paper senior researchers nowadays that's also violated a beginner researcher could be asked to submit a review paper a beginner researcher could be requested to be an editorial member of that fake journal So you can imagine how the scientific community is really spoiled. The science negotiable malam. ስለዚህ ምን ለብሰው ጫማ ምናም ቻይና ይያል ነው ማቴሪያል ወርልድ ያስጨነቀ አሁን ደግሞ በሳይንስ እየተጨነቀን ነው። ያ ማለት ሁሉም ይታተም ፔፐር ሁሉ ፔፐር አይደለም ስለዚህ ወሸት ፔፐር አለ። እዚያ ወሸት ፔፐር ጋር ታይዞ ደግሞ የሚመጣ የተለያዩ የሰው ልጅ ፍላጎቶች ይኖራሉ ማለት ነው። So that story will take us with this predatory publication what is it predatory publishing is a right only publishing just only right you write it as it is you could simply say he are or they is say you accept it no problem the first time you want to be asked for money because you have to be looked into the system through time you'll be asked for money that is a trick and it is only publishing misleading publishing abusive academic publishing without checking manuscript for quality legitimacy and preview and archival procedures these are the four criteria of or qualities of a publication or a journal in order to say a journal it should be what it should be a, it should qualify it should be legitimate it should be pre-reviewed meaning if I have a manuscript then my manuscript should be sent to someone who has the same or above experience or profession in that particular field of research so he judge and he give his decision and the decision could be accepted or rejected as I've said earlier so this term predatory publication was coined by a Canadian librarian Jeffrey Beal in 2010, through time he was very much suspicious because he got online journals and he tried to investigate whether they are really journals or not. He came up with thousands and thousands of journals and publishers. Then he released it on the net, but later he was threatened. Why? Why threatened? By who? These merchants. The merchants who coined the name journal, they are attacking him. So they tried to also make an appeal on a court and a justice, and then he was frustrated. But the lists are there. They are valuable information for the scientific community. He was, of course, harassed, and his activity was interrupted. And what they do, these predatory publishers, and I'm really sorry, this is the main part, I will take some more time. They perform activities like legitimate journals, but they have illegitimate open access journals. Most of the predatory publishers, what? They exercise their activity online because of technologies. But they have illegitimate journals, they have illegitimate publishers, they have illegitimate scientific conferences. They, most of the time, use what? Best names. They are called what? Predatory publishers. They have to predate us. Nyamatals Lalabacho, they always use the best journal names, like International Journal of, American Journal of, European Journal of, African Journal of, blah, blah. One of the fake publishers is called Academic Journals. This Academic Journals, look, it has one, this figure was 3 years ago, 112 journals. A publisher could have what, either one or more journals. This fake publisher has got 112 journals. And one of the journals, this is African Journal of Biotechnology, where most of our researchers in Ethiopia has been, I think, cheated out of. Senior researchers have been submitting and they publish a paper on African Journal of Biotechnology, but that's a fake journal. So this belongs to fake Nigerian publishers, and it is withdrawn from the scientific community. So they send threats of email, as I have said it, and in their mail, they try to state something which is not in line with scientific or a journal's criteria. They try to mention so far published number, a number of download articles. We could download even Google, various information from Google. So there is nothing new for download. It's not a criteria after all about journal or publication. And the number of views. Yeah, you don't say what you do, it's a good thing. You don't track marks if you mail it. In your journal, in your social media, but in your journal, that's the point. So now the point is, who is most at risk from predatory journals? Beginner researchers are highly affected. Where? From Africa and Latin America and Asia. And in the case of university, young or inexperienced researchers or graduate students with little or no information about predatory publications. So they still use some words which are not in line with the journal. They used, for example, Institute for Science Information. The abbreviation is the same, ISI, but the correct abbreviation is a green one, which is called Institute for Scientific Information. They also try to write and convince us by writing our global impact factor is 4.5, blah, blah, blah. But the right term is journal impact factor. Of course, nowadays, the matrix is not only journal impact factors. Journal impact factors is a matrix, a quality measurement for which publisher? For which? Web of Science. There is also Scopus. Scopus uses what? Cytoscope. So, probably in the coming few years, they might come up with a new word which really correlates with what? Cytoscope. Maybe they will say Cytoscope, but something like that. It is the same story in the business world, like Sony, Sony. Yeah? It's the same. So these people, they use foggy operations, making money while failing to deliver on their claims of being open access and failing to provide services such as peer review and archiving. Therefore, if we are trying to submit and publish, it's totally what? Unethical. And it is a scientific misconduct. So there is, let me show you this figure. This study was conducted in 2017 by Moher. And what he did was he tried to collect publications from country or continent purpose with incomes also. From lower incomes, he took Nigeria and Egypt as a sample. From middle income, this country, and high income. And you can imagine, India is the top most country which is highly affected by predatory publication. But the surprise is, look here, US is also, the bar for US is too large. Why? Lemon, nasu yallacho scientific community awareness training munu munu yallacho lemon yekefal. Lemon deno. Because most of these tech publishers are based in either Europe or in the US. And they, that's one reason. The second reason is the co-authors. Co-authors could be there. And hence, because of that reasons, you can imagine how the bar for the US is also getting higher. This is also a study by Scopus. The study conducted from 2010 to 14 for 4 years. By 2010, the number of predatory papers were 53,000. In 4 years, the number goes up to what? 420,000 articles. Fake articles, fake papers. You can imagine how the number would be now in 2021. በ2014 ዓለምን ያጠለቀለቀ 420,000 የውሸት ፔፐር አለ ኦንላይን። አስቡት ይሄን ደግሞ በእናንተ ፊልድ ስትገቡ ስታገኙት ጎግል ስኮላር ወይ ምናምን የጥሩ ነው ብላችሁ ሳይትም ታደርጉታላችሁ። So, as I have said it, a journal could have what? Either one, publisher could have one journal, that is one journal publisher. But most journals have got what? Two or more journals. These fake predatory publishers, they have what? 100 plus, most of the time. Because they have to grant, collect money. They track one journal for all fields, most of the time. One journal, journal, blah, blah, and every field is there. Natural, social, engineering, blah, blah. Because the ultimate purpose is no scientific integrity or quality, but money or business. There is also another problem, which we call it hijacked journals. Hijacked journals, the legitimate academic journals for which duplicate or fake websites are created. Because of technology, internet, most of the time important for us, pencils, but there is also a drawback. Look here, this is the genuine journal of Iceland. It's a geology journal, which name is called Jokul, Jokul Research Journal. Just they imitate and they create a false journal, which they call it Jokul Journal. So you can imagine, we have to be very careful, even when we try to submit, probably from your colleague, from others, you know, they're famous journal in your field, you have to be very careful before you submit your manuscript. Yeah, you know, there's a easy way to make it. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Leila, the editorial members, he called, submit him, I'm going to watch a paper, come ask at them, here I say, name member, come, pay him, so he asked him, ከሚያስከሳፉ ሰዎች ወይም ደግሞ ጽፌ የኔ ብዙ ማሳተፍታት ሶፍ አኒቲካል ሌላውን እድል ነው እየወሰድን ያለ ነው። ሌላው ኤክሰስስ ኮሳይቴሽን ሳይት አርግልኝ ሳይት ላርግልሽ እንደዚህ አይነት የማይገናኘው ሳይት ማለት ባይ ዘ ወይ የአዲስ አበባ ዩኒቨርሲቲ ምክትል ፕሬዚዳንት የምርምር ምክትል ፕሬዚዳንት ሂልተን ሆቴል ላይ የዛሬ 2 ዓመት ያለችው እስካሁን እና ያረሳኝም ከዚህም ጋር ስለ ሪሰርች ኢንቴክስ እና ስለ ፕሪዳቶሪ ፓብሊኬሽን በጣም ተጨንቀ ስናወራ ጀነራል ዲስከሽን ላይ እጇን አንስታ አዲስ አበባ ዩኒቨርሲቲ ድር እንዳለ ታውቃላችሁ አለች። ድር ምን ችግር አለው? ሰዎች ነን ስንኖር ማህበራዊ ሁሉም ነገር አስፈልጊ ነው። ሶ ዋት ዋትስ ኒው እንትና የሚገርማችሁ አለች። ተመራማሪዎች ምሁራኖች አንድ ላይ ሆነው የፔፐር ድርም ተጀምሯል። አንዱ ሌሎችን ያስገባ ሌላው ሲያሰጥም ያን ያስገባ ፊልዱም አንድ አይደለም በዚያ ሰዎች ያድጋሉ። ይሄ ደግሞ ከሪሰርች ቲክሱም የባሰ የማይመለከተው ሰው ስሙን ኢንትሮ ተደርጎ አንተ እኔን አስገባኝ እኔም አስገባሃለሁ እየተባለ we have reached to that level. You can imagine how science is spoiled. Really devastating and frustrating. ሌላው ደግሞ በዩኒቨርሲቲዎች አካባቢ ትልቁ ችግሩ ይሄ ነው። gift authorship. እንደምታውቁት ዩኒቨርሲቲ አሁን እኛ የሰው ችግር አለብን ብዬ አላስብም። capacity አድርገን ያለን ሰው በዩኒቨርሲቲ ራም ማድረግ እንችላለን ብዬ አስባለሁ። I don't understand the reason behind why we're still recruiting Indians. I'm really sorry if there's an Indian here. But we do have several universities. We graduate several PhD students, PhD graduates, master graduates. We can capacitate and we can handle our service. Because of also the shortage for foreign currencies, I am not clear why still are trying to recruit. But the story is different, what I try to say. And what you think other? What do you mean about that? They have to stay. I'm going to tell you. Paper is not good, sir. Here is the paper, your name is here. ባልሰራህበት በለለህበት ስምህ ተጽፎ ፔፐር ይሰጣል። ዛት ኢዝ ዋት ሙስና አካዳሚክ ኮራፕሽን ሚንስ ሂር ጊፍት ኦተርሺፕ The best example of academic corruption. That's quite common in our university, by the way. It is quite common because they have to survive, they have to wait. So they are really heavy paid.
Yeah.
So, contributing factors, as I've said it, beginners. Lamaj, lahulum nagar ikallata. The scientific publication world to mikallata. Hello? Neta of Saskatan Kaladuk? Sanabatala. Then nagar simata, what a publication per orta, even people you tanja, I don't care. Predatory immune, you know, as I yellow. What is that thing ever?
Lelo? Technology. Challenge on a bin, technology.
Internet, you know? Which in our search online line does you lend like as you get to Imanam the online Ganzab Latin in number, but Mutta was also me laka Ganzab Chitty. Anum online, the journal Hachak Namar Yagalakalan,
which means inexperienced and known in the Takalan. Lena, we open access in MIPA.
Offline number journal, Aun Kaker Gizay, 2-3 decades, we don't know. Open access system on us, Sudamo, Lelevoch, Wemdemo, the science and the garage, but I'm
Mutual Gatami Fatara Lachoman.
Now, as a Minister of Science and Education, what do I advise? Last year, we tried to prepare and circulate an academic promotion guideline. With that, we clearly stated that publishing in predatory publication is unethical, and hence we said that for each academic staff to be promoted, he has to exercise or he has to follow the first 3 dotted publishers or indexing databases, sorry. These are what we call indexing databases. By the way, Google Scholar is not an indexing database. Google is not indexing database. By definition, all online portals are not indexing database. Bizuk zeyen promotion guidelines in Nasara, bizu comment illaka. Google Scholar lemin algeba. Mil kein wasti lu hasab derso. Takabbalana. Google Scholar ko nanta Google lab tilakut. የፍቅር ደብዳቤ ምን ሊወጣ ይችላል? It's not an indexing database. Indexing database by definition means it is a scientific database where they try to scrutinize the qualified or the right publishers and the right journals. Then they every year make a criteria, they list and they release. These are what we call indexing databases. So the scopus, the web page there with a web of science, of course the famous and the oldest one, and of course the PubMed. PubMed, by the way, was included or as a cert because of the comment we received from Gondar University. Otherwise, almost all the papers in PubMed are appeared either in Scopus or in the Web of Science. So the best advice is, it is really hard to look for this predatory or not. You waste your time. Focus on this because each indexing database has got thousands of publishers and thousands of journals. Journals ሌላ ውስጥ ገብተን የፕሪዳቶር ነው አይደለም ይላል መልፋት የለብንም ስለዚህ ሚኒስቴር መሳቢቱ አፕሩቭ ያረጋቸው እነዚህ ናቸው እነዚህ ደግሞ በሁሉ ፊልድ ብዙ እንትናላቸው እንት በእነዚህ ላይ መጠንቀቅ ለምሳሌ ሌላው እነዚህ ስኮፕ ዌብ ኦፍ ሳይንስ እና ፓብሜድ ማለት ደግሞ it doesn't mean that they are always perfect every year you have to closely follow በየአመቱ አንዳንድ ጆርናል ሜሪቱን የማይሟላ እና ኳሊቲ ማይኖር ከሆነ ምን ያረጋታል withdraw ያረጋታል suspend ያረጋታል ስለዚህ እሱንም መከተል መቻል አለብን ማለት ነው እነዚህን ለጥንቃቄ ነው otherwise we focus on this so why worry on predatory publication taking back to my first slide it as a person it affects us it also affects the image of the nation nowadays west africa india are well known in predatory publication if we are not very careful the name ethiopia will be included in the near future so we have to be very careful and it reduces globally I told you why on continent because it reduces our what research and development ranking. There is an organization with United Nations, which we call it WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. Every year they released Innovation Index. And one of the criteria for Innovation Index is quality publications and scientific activity. If we produce millions of predatory papers, it doesn't help our country. They want to be considered to rank Ethiopia. So we have to be very careful. And you can imagine how predatory publication even affects the rank of our country. And the image is it affect us, it affect our colleagues, it affect the public, it affect the university, it affect the funder, and it affect the continent. So the exercise in some countries, they retract what? Papers. It atom paper, ekele minam yitabalo, tanestor yitabalo, respect miyasata nagri metal. Academic award, MS thesis in a PhD, takamutol, yawaksa inoski, tajamron, plagiarism, samtachwan, lelo chinoosi maizfafa, patumkinatillam. ሌላው ታይትል ኢቭን ፕሮሞሽንም ራሱ ፕሮፌሰርን ማንሳት አሶሺየትን ማንሳት አሲስታንት የሆነን ማንሳት ምክንያቱም የሆነበት በፕሪዳቶሪ ፓብሊኬሽን ከሆነ እንደዚህ አይነት አለ ኢትዮጵያ ላይ ይመጣል ነው ስለዚህ ተንቀቅ ማለት ነው ማለት ነው
ሌላው ሳኪንግ ፍሮም ጆብ ከስራ መባረር ያመጣል ይሄ ከሳውዝ አፍሪካም ራሱ ኦርድ የተደረገ ነው እኛ ኮንቲኔንት አፍሪካ
So what to do? I think the university research vice presidents, research directors, and research officials, you have to closely follow and release the information to researchers. So publishers, research institutes, and educational funders should issue explicit warning against illegitimate publishers and develop recommendations on public integrity. And remarks to be considered by this organization provides a list of legitimate journals. For example, from the promotion guidelines that we have released, go to Scopus, list all the fields, circulate to different departments. Train researchers about scientific integrity, particularly about predatory publication. And audit guarantee, and when seeking for promotion, really look if that is predatory publication or not. I think that has been issued as of October 2013, and that is what we have said now. And even that guideline has been requested by research institutes. They are also following the same track. And during conducting research, during proposal write-up, there should be a space or an annex where the researchers have to declare that they not only will follow research ethics, but also they will not submit what? The manuscript to predatory publication. The same is true for project activities in universities. And the reform in motion, as I told you, I think I better go to directly to the publication where we make, this is it, yeah. This is up. So we have this directive where we try to state academic promotion criteria based on what? Based on the proclamation given to the ministry. And it says that every institution shall have rules and procedures on employment and promotion of its academic staff consistent with international practices. Some researchers ask, why is Moshe developing a promotion guide? That's again is a Senate legislation, blah, blah. No, but Moshe has a responsibility to make sure, because Moshe is coordinating science, and we are responsible to make science with equality and with an international standard. We do have also, we also try to make, enhance the quality and visibility of our national journals. As you all know, we have now accredited 16 journals as of last year. With this year, we have received more than 48 journals to be accredited. We will continue this indirectly. The quality and the visibility of our journals will be increased. And there might, there could be little chance of adding the impact of predatory publications. ሌላው ተጨማሪ ጀርናሎቻችን ኳሊቲ እና ቪዚቢሊቲያቸውን ከጨመር ግሎባል ኢንዴክስ ዴሞን ቻንሳቸውንም እንጨምራለን ማለት ነው። ኢትዮጵያን ኤዲተርስ ጆርናል ፎረምስ አቋቁመናል ምክንያቱም ሞሸ ብቻውን ይሰራ የለም እንደ ፕሮፌሽናል ሶሳይቲ እነዚህ አቋቁመናቸው ከኢትዮጵያን አካዳሚ ሳይንስ ጋር ነው እነሱ የጆርናሎችን ኳሊቲ የሚኒስቴር መስሪያ ቤቱ መስራት ያለበትን ነገር በጋራ እንሰራለን ይሄ ትልቅ አሴት ነው የተለያዩ የሪሰርች ኢቲክስ ሳይንቲፊክ ኢንተግሪቲ ሪስፖንሲብል ኮንዳክት ኦፍ ሪሰርች ስልጠናዎችን እንሰጣለን አንዱ ይሄ የዚያ ፓርት ነው ማለት ነው በመጨረሻም this is my message the ethics of course his message but the message that I really like the ethics of science regards the search for truth as one of the highest duties of man ethics has been well called the religion of science he's an American scientist who lived from 63 to 52 thank you so much
አጠጣጭ ወጥ
Thank you. Thank you for your nice presentation, Dr. Salamone.